Hi everyone, it's David, your English teacher. Today we're going to talk about state verbs. We're finally going to understand them. Welcome to lesson number 9. So there's a rule when it comes to state verbs. State verbs are verbs that you can't see somebody doing. Before we actually understand state verbs, we have to understand verbs themselves. There are some verbs out there that we can actually see people doing them, such as riding your bicycle, or playing basketball, or eating breakfast, or something like this. These are things that we can actually see people doing. So those are action verbs, like play, like watch TV, like read a book. I can see people doing those things. But then we have verbs that you cannot see people doing those things. And that's what a stative verb is. So here's a whole list. Here we go. In this video, you can see a dog. You see the dog right now. You can maybe even hear the dog right now. I'm sure that you want the dog because it's so cute. So even if it's happening right now, as you notice, a want is a feeling, right? But I can't see how you feel when you see this dog. I don't even say right now that you're seeing the dog. I say that you see the dog. And maybe you like the dog. Maybe you even know the dog. And right now, I'm using this dog as an example to teach stative verbs so you understand that even if it's in the moment, I'm not putting any ing on this thing. There's no process because you can't see these things. I don't know what you believe and I don't know what you know, even if it's right now. I think this dog knows right now that the day is beautiful and I think that it loves the weather. But maybe it prefers indoors instead of outdoors. I don't know. But again, guys, the biggest thing about these verbs that you see in front of you, see, hear, smell, taste, and feel, your senses, your thoughts, a belief, what you believe, or if you forget, or if you guess, or if you know, or if you think, or if you understand, even if it's right now, we don't put ing. And feelings. You can dislike it right now, or you can enjoy it right now, but I don't put ing in there at all. I don't know. I hope that you like these things. I hope. I don't say I'm hoping. So again, senses, thoughts, feelings, and possessions. Possessions, that's clearly something that doesn't change. You can say I have a dog, or I own a dog, or that this dog belongs to me. But I don't say this dog is belonging to me. I don't say that I am having a dog. I don't say that I am owning a dog. I have a dog, I own a dog, and the dog belongs to me. By the way, I hope you really, really like dogs. Now, I want to move over and forward to doing some exercises together where you're going to identify the mistake and then you're going to give me the correction. So I have about 7 to 8 questions like this, and that will be it for today. And again, you can check out my website at davidenglish.info, or you could even go there to do some exercises that I have up there ready for you to go. And let's continue. I want you to change from progressive into present simple, this sentence. So you're going to find the mistake, and then you're going to fix it. Let's try it out. I am liking this new approach to work. Gotta make the I am liking into present simple for a stative verb. What do you think? I like this new approach to work. I like this new approach to work. Correct. They are having some doubts about the project. What do you think? Again, we cannot say they're having, we must say they have some doubts about the project. He is feeling a bit uncertain about the decision. What do you think? correction, he feels a bit uncertain about the decision. We are seeming quite confident in our presentation. We are seeming? We seem quite confident in our presentation. The team is wanting a better solution. The team wants a better solution. The new dish is tasting great. Nope. What do you think? The new dish tastes great. Mwah. They are hearing the music from downstairs. They hear the music from downstairs. I am seeing the problem clearly now. I am seeing the problem clearly now. I see the problem clearly now. Now, after completing this video and the exercises, I know that you understand stative verbs much better. Again, you cannot see these verbs. You cannot see these actions. It's not like running. It's not like jumping. It's not like presenting. It's not like introducing. You cannot see these verbs happening, even if they are right now in the moment. Very important. But guess what? For lesson 10, we're going to be doing present progressive, where you actually see these actions happening. But they're very important because they have three rules, and I'm sure you don't know what they are. And if you do, let me know in the comments. Now, if you want to have the quiz that we just have for this lesson on stative verbs, you can check it out on my website at davidenglish.info. I would like to see you there. You're going to have the exercises for each lesson there. I'll see you in the next lesson, and have a great day.